Mr. P.K.D. Nambiar, political analyst, joining us. Mr. Nambiar, now according to reports, the BJP is likely to get about 24 odd seats in Tamil Nadu. The Congress also may not get a very high number of seats. Is this a reflection of the ground realities, where the national parties really stand in Tamil Nadu?
So I believe the 24 number which you are mentioning would be too low, looking at the stature of the party. It's a ruling party at the center, and also it has, from the last 1 year of the performance, BJP, if you're looking at the ground, has been phenomenal. All the central leadership is putting its wonderful show there so far, and also the BJP in the state, in Tamil Nadu, has been able to get attraction to from a large number of good leaders from across, both from the other political parties, also from the bureaucrats to the sign actors who are coming in. I believe that may be too low a number from that point of view of such a cadre party. I think it should be more than 50 to 60 is what I believe that the BJP is going to get.
The official numbers are not out yet, so maybe the BJP will get high number of seats. These are media reports that the BJP is likely to get about 20-25 seats. Now, sir, elsewhere, in any other part of the country, Mr. Narendra Modi is a big vote catcher for the BJP. Even Mr. Amit Shah is a force to reckon with. Then you have leaders like Mr. Yogi Adityanath, who is seen as a rising star within the BJP. Do they matter in Tamil Nadu as well? Can they swing elections in Tamil Nadu?
It does. See, I'll tell you, there are two things. In politics, what we generally say, there is one, is the people who are the loyal cadres. And in Tamil Nadu specifically, for an example, DMK, AIADMK and BJP, all of them are cadre parties. The rest of the people are not cadre parties. They are primarily driven by some sentiments or some kind of a base. That's it. So these cadre parties, other than that, a large number of pen sitters you will find in politics, especially in Tamil Nadu too, who may not have any specific, in marketing technique, which you say the people who are ambivalent. So those people will be very, very effectively, and especially with Modi, have been talking about Tamil Nadu, Tamil culture, Tamil as a language and etc. in multiple platforms from the last 1.5-2 years, quite extensively. I believe, of course, with that kind of an emotional connect what he has been able to create, which has never happened in the history of with any other prime minister towards Tamil Nadu. So I am sure that a huge amount of traction is happening towards BJP, which has never ever happened in the history. Now, I don't know, I'm not too sure about how will that convert that into terms of number of votes, but looking at the kind of sentiment which is happening, even the Vetuvel Yatra and etc., the kind of huge crowd was all along and across the Tamil Nadu as a state, clearly shows that BJP is going to be doing much better than what it was. And
right.
Secondly, and you remember that the Mahabalipuram, the Chinese premier and that kind of, so Modi is maybe the one of the very few prime ministers who had given immense respect and plus time, money, everything to the Tamil Nadu as a state. And
right.
People of Tamil Nadu do understand that.
Right. And Mr. Nambiar, finally, do many Tamils still see the national parties, the BJP and the Congress, as outsiders, party of the Hindi heartland, particularly in the case of the BJP? In West Bengal, for instance, Mamata Banerjee is bringing this up, isn't it? She's asserting that her party, TMC, belongs to Bengal, while the BJP is an outsider. Is that something, is that an issue in this election as well?
So let me tell you one thing. Today we are living in a digital world. Any party, whether it is Mamata or even from the point of view of a DMK, is talking about that very regional kind of a politics will not work. People are aware about what is happening not only within India or also elsewhere in the world. So a prime minister or a national party like BJP, for an example, in Kerala has got almost 15.5% of the vote in Kerala. So, Karnataka, it is already ruling. You have seen that the Hyderabad election quite recently, that how it has emerged almost like the number two. So, I think BJP is its existence in these domains, even it goes back to the Janasangha such time, and RSS is very deep rooted in the entire across South Indian states. So calling them an outsider on a Hindi heartland party may be going against whether it is Mamta or even for that matter to Tamil Nadu or elsewhere. Secondly, when it comes to West Bengal, for an example, look at the number of assembly seats and the Lok Sabha seats the MPs BJP is having. Look at the way number of leaders and ministers are quitting TMC and joining BJP. What else kind of a proof is required for any of for Mamta or for that matter any other people? I think the traction towards BJP, I mean the untouchability which many people in the past used to talk about BJP is either over or it has come down quite
drastically. All right, sir. Mr. Nambiar, thank you.